Welcome to the second 1 minute Wednesday, and this week is all about what I think is the most important element in creating a realistic image, and that is shadows.
So this is an image called palm tree, and to make it look realistic, the tree needs a shadow. So I'm going to go to my tree layer and I'm going to duplicate it. I'm going to go back to the original, which will become the shadow layer, and we're going to select the transform tool, hold down command or control, and drag the shadow in the opposite direction of the source of light. Now, shadows have a couple of characteristics that make them look realistic, and they are that the further away from the subject the shadow gets, the lighter it gets, and also the softer it gets. So I'm gonna hover over the shadow layer, hold down Command or Control, and click the layer to bring up the marching ants. I'm then gonna make sure that this layer is rasterized. I'm gonna go to the gradient tool, and I'm gonna paint from black to white and drag out a gradient probably twice the length of this shadow. I'm gonna go Command or Control D to deselect the selection, and I'm then gonna go from normal to multiply in my blend modes. I'm gonna go to Convert to Smart Object on the shadow layer. I'm gonna go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. And that's currently set to 3.5, which actually doesn't look too bad. I'm gonna click OK. I'm then gonna go to the mask on my smart filters and drag out another gradient, probably a bit shorter this time. And that's gonna mean that the blur is only applied gradually the further away from the tree it gets. I'm gonna go to Edit, Transform, and Warp, because my hand isn't flat and therefore the shadow shouldn't be flat. So I'm gonna drag the shadow to the shape that my hand is set in the photo. It looks a little bit strong, so I'm gonna bring down the opacity. And that is that. Hope that was useful. Thank you for watching. Thank you.